In this video, we're going to evaluate an energy-saving Joule thief. Here's an example of such a circuit that I've just put together on some breadboard. And the reason is I had these broken garden lights that are LED lights that I wanted to run. They're 12-volt lights, and I wanted to run them off a 1.5-volt battery, such as this one here, or a supercapacitor. And I'm probing the emitter collector on the transistor with an oscilloscope, and you can just see the trace in the upper left corner there of the output running at 1.5 volts. The problem with these type of circuits, Joule thieves, is they typically generate around 40 volts at high frequency. And so if you want to run a 12-volt LED, you're wasting a lot of energy. So this circuit is modified, and I'm going to be comparing two different circuits, but it's modified to lower the voltage based on setting a resistor. And you can see that variable resistor on the circuit board there. So here's the circuit diagram, and you can see that as that capacitor charges up, the gate on that MOSFET, the IRFP830 MOSFET, gets more positive. The MOSFET turns on, and electrons flow onto that base of that MPSA06 transistor, turning the transistor off and shutting down or decreasing the oscillations, which then decreases the voltage on the capacitor. The voltage on the capacitor is also being used by the load, which also helps to decrease it. So in a way, it's sort of it regulates the voltage on the capacitor and regulates the output of the Joule thief, and therefore prolongs the length of time that the Joule thief operates, making it more efficient. So that's the premise. So here's the output on the LED. It's running that 12-volt garden LED pretty brightly. And here's what the scope shot looks like right there. And now I'm going to decrease the voltage on the gate, which should reduce voltage, the average voltage on the capacitor, and therefore the LED has gone off. Now as the average voltage on the capacitor, the 2.2 microfarad capacitor, goes up, the LED comes back on. In this variation of the circuit, I've removed the MOSFET, and I'm just using the central part to change the voltage on the base of the transistor. So as the capacitor charges up, the base of the transistor becomes more negative. As it becomes more negative, the transistor gets shut down. So what we've done is we've charged this ultracapacitor to 1.9 volts, and we're going to compare the two circuits with a 1.9 volt charge on this capacitor to see which one runs longer. The LED ran for 7 hours without the MOSFET, and with the MOSFET ran for about 9 hours. So it looks like this one wins out. With this particular circuit, the final voltage on the supercapacitor was 1 volt when the light went off. With regular white LEDs, you can let the voltage go down a whole lot lower to 0.3 volts, so it'll go pretty much for several more hours. Thanks for watching.